Okay, first of all, morning to all of you. By the grace of great, by your great, Nanda Shukla Ramdasi. Let us start with today's lecture. See, our today's lecture is also very much important. Our today's lecture is type of optical fiber. But before going to discuss the types of optical fiber, we would like to discuss what is optical fiber. Optical fiber kya hota hai? What is optical fiber? So it is a very great revolution in the field of data transfer, in the field of to transfer the energy from one point to the another point. What do you mean by optical fiber? What is optical fiber? Optical fiber mein kya hota hai basically? Optical fiber consists of three parts. One part is called the first part is called a core, which core is surrounded by the clad, and the outer part is called a sheath or outer jacket. Okay. And the most important point is the refractive index of clad is slightly less than the refractive index of the core, and the energy will transfer through the core part only. And the energy will transfer through the core part only. And optical fiber is mainly dependent upon the phenomenon which is called a TIR, which means total internal reflection. That we have also discussed in the last lecture, and you have also studied this part in your lower classes. Okay. Now see, this is the topic is the type of optical fiber. The optical fiber is called basically two types, step index fiber and graded index fiber. Step means this is a step, that is what is called a step. Graded means variation. See, this is a variation, that is what is called a grade. It's called a graded index fiber. Further, step index fiber classified into two types. One mode is called a single mode fiber, and another mode is called a multi mode fiber. And this single mode fiber can be written as SMF, and multi mode fiber is written as a MMF. Some books written as a SMF, and some books written as a MMF. Similarly, the graded index fiber is further classified into two types. One mode is called a single mode fiber and a multi-mode fiber. So it is called a graded index single mode fiber, and the second is called a graded index multi-mode fiber. Okay. Now we will discuss step by step. The first type is called a step index fiber. Why it is called a step? Now see, this is the setup of the optical fiber. This is the core part. And this is the clad part. What is the refractive index of core? L1. The refractive index of core is L1, and the refractive index of clad is L2. And L2 must be slightly greater than the, sorry, slightly less than the L1. Or L1 must be slightly higher than the L2. Now see, we have to see the variation of refractive index versus distance. Okay. Now let us say this d is the diameter of core. This small d is called a diameter of the core. And now see, along this axis we are taking the refractive index m. Along the y axis and along the x axis we are taking r. R is the distance from the center of the core. Now see, within the core. So this is the diameter. So from the core boundary start from here and ends at this point. Okay. Within the core, the value of the refractive index is uniform. I would say the N1 is uniform within the core. I mean to say N1 is constant within the core. So that is why we have taken N1 is constant. Now see, N1 is constant. All the values are same. This value corresponds to this point, this value corresponds to this point, this value corresponds to this point, and this value corresponds to this point. So the value of refractive index N1 is constant throughout the core. And see, as we come across the boundary of the core and clad interface, what will happen? It will suddenly drop from N1 to N2. Let us say N1 is 5. And let us assume that N2 is 4.5. Because slightly less than L1 is 5, N2 is 4.5. Now see, this is called a 5. This value corresponds to the 5 and N2 corresponds to the 4.5. Now see, this value abruptly, N1 abruptly, environment abruptly changes to N1 abruptly changes to N2. Okay, N1 abruptly changes to N2. So see, if we draw the diagram, now we get a step. So this is called a step. So that is why it is called a step index. This is called a step index fiber. And this diagram is also called the index profile. This is called the index profile of the optical fiber. This diagram is also called the index fiber of the optical fiber. See, now within the gland, N2 is again uniform. N2 is again uniform or constant. So this is the basic setup. N1 is uniform within the core, N2 is uniform within the gland. But as we reach at the boundary of the core gland interface, N1 abruptly changes to N2. So that is what is called a, if we draw the graph of N versus R, so we get a step. See, this is the variation of N1. N1 is constant, and as we reach at the surface, at the core gland interface, it abruptly changes from N1 to N2. So this is how we get a graph. Okay. Now see, this is the relation. If small d is called a diameter of the core. Okay, this is a standard relation. NA is called numerical aperture. NA is called a numerical aperture. What's the meaning of numerical aperture? In the last lecture, we have discussed the numerical aperture. It will definitely come. It will definitely ask for the examiner. What is numerical aperture? Numerical aperture is the sign of the acceptance angle. That is the sine theta naught. But actually, what is the physical significance of numerical aperture? If numerical aperture is more, it means it will take more light. It will capture more light, and more light will get amplified. Amplified means more energy will transfer from one point to the another point. Okay. So numerical aperture is directly related to the intake capacity of the optical fiber. Okay. Now see, if this relation is true, it means such a mode is called a multimode fiber. Then we call it as a step index multimode fiber. Then we call it as a step index single mode fiber. If D is less than, agar ye relation true nahi hota hai, if this relation is not satisfied, I mean to say if D is less than 0.66 lambda by numerical aperture, then only a single mode can propagate through the fiber. It means this is called a step index single mode fiber. Okay, तो ये ऊपर वाला मल्टीमोड था, ऊपर वाला क्या था? मल्टीमोड था, ठीक है? अगर ये इक्वेशन सेटिस्फाई होती है, then it's called a multimode fiber. If this equation is not correct, if D is less than 0.766 lambda by NA, then it is called a single mode fiber. सेटिस्फाई होती है तो मल्टीमोड, नहीं होती है अगर D less आता है, अगर इनक्वालिटी D less than आती है इस फैक्टर से, स्टैंडर्ड रिलेशन से, तो हमारे पास क्या आता है? सिंगल मोड फाइबर. एंड डाउट फॉर दिस पॉइंट. Only this part is important. Okay. Now we will come across the graded index. Graded means variation. Graded means जैसे हम बोलते हैं कि किसी बच्चों को क्लास को दिया A grade या B grade. So the grade does not give us the exact value. Okay. So it tells about the variation. Now we have to take the variation of N versus R. We have to take the variation of refractive index versus R. Now see, this is called a graded index fiber. So graded means the name itself suggests that there will be some variation. Now draw the N versus R. Now see, at the center of core, the refractive index is maximum, and that value is called N10. N10 means refractive index of core at the center. Okay. Again, we use the standard relation N1R is equal to N10 square root of 1 minus 2 delta R upon A the power alpha. Now see, as we move away from the center, what will happen? The refractive index is changing. Like we can say that at the center point, let us say it is 5. So at the center point, it is 5. As we move away from the core, center of the core, it is changing. Let us say this point. At this point, what is the value? It would be, let us say 4.9. Then at the next point, 4.7, are you able to find? This is 0.1234. Let us take for the sake of simplicity, for the sake of understanding, I am taking two, four points arbitrarily. Let us say the value of refractive index is 5 at the center, and it is a maximum, and it is a maximum at the center of the pool. And, but as we move away from the center, the refractive index changes. The refractive index changes. Let us say for arbitrarily this point is, let us say this A, this, let us say this is O, this is A. And at the A point, let us say the value is 4.9. At point B, the value is 4.8. And at point C is 4.7. Now we can see the difference. The value of the refractive index is changing from the center of the core. And at this point, as we reach at the core line interface, the variation starts from the center of the core and terminate at the core clad interface. So we get this variation. Okay. Similarly on this side. Okay. So that is why we are getting a grade. This is called a graded index fiber. We are getting a graded index fiber at the center. The refractive index value is a maximum, but as we move away from the center of this side or this side, the value of the refractive index is changing, and it will reach at this point, and it will attain a minimum value. At this point, which is called a core-clad interface. Again, as we reach at the core-clad interface, the value of the refractive index is N2 within the clad. Now let us make a index profile. Let us make a ray diagram of this grid index fiber. But before going to discuss this diagram, so this is a standard relation N1R. What is N1R? N1 is the value of refractive index at any point R, at any arbitrary point R. So that is why I am showing at this point the value of refractive index is N10. And this curve shows the N1R. N1R means the value of the refractive index with respect to point R. Okay, so N1R is equal to N10 square root of 1 minus 2 delta R by A raised to power alpha. What is delta? In the last lecture we discussed, what is delta? Delta is called a fractional change in refractive index of core and clad. Okay, so delta is equal to N1 minus N2 divided by A. Can you tell me the basic difference between these two diagrams, between these two index profiles? What is the basic difference? Yahan pe within the core, the value of the N1 is uniform, but here the value of the N1 is not a uniform. And it is a constantly variable from the center to the core clad. Okay, now see, this is delta, this alpha is called an index parameter, and generally value of alpha is equal to 2. This value has been decided by the manufacturer. Okay, jo banata hai wo uski decide karta hai, because this value of alpha is equal to 2. Now let us make this diagram. This is very complicated picture. Ray 1 is called the axial ray. Now see, the important point is the value of the refractive index is changing within the core. The value of refractive index is changing within the core. What does this mean? Iska kya matlab hua? Now see, refractive index is directly proportional to C by V. Refractive index is directly proportional to C by V. If the refractive index is more, then the velocity will minimum. If the refractive index is maximum, it means the velocity will be minimum. So simply we can say that if the refractive index is more, we can say that the velocity of the light will get slowed down. Refractive index ज़्यादा होने का मतलब यह है कि traffic ज़्यादा है, तो speed कम हो जाएगी. Refractive index कम होने का मतलब क्या है कि आप national highway में जा रहे हैं, ठीक है? Road खाली है तो speed बढ़ जाएगी. अब देखो यहाँ पे देखो, ray one is called axial ray, ray one is called a सबसे ज़्यादा refractive index की value कहाँ पे है? Can you tell me at what point the value of the refractive index is maximum? At the axis. Because at the axis, at the axis, the value of the refractive index is N10. It is called N10. That is the maximum value. That is the maximum value. But now see, for the ray 2 and ray 3, ray 2 and ray 3 are called the marginal rays. Okay. Now the for ray 2 and similarly for ray 3, the ray 2 is entering from कहां से enter कर रही है बताओ? Ray 2 is entering from ray 1 is taking 0 angle. Ray 1 is taking a 0 angle with the axis of curve. Okay. And it will suffer a maximum and it will face a maximum refractive index value. And it will face a maximum value of refractive index. As a result, the speed of ray 1 will slow down. The speed of the ray 1 will slow down. What about the ray 2? Please tell. बताइए क्या होगा ray 2 की
velocity 11 होगी बात
ray 2 क्या होगा ray 2 कहां से कहां जा रही है ray 2 is traveling from low refractive index to high refractive index और high refractive index to low refractive index ray 2 is entering from high refractive index to low refractive index और low refractive index to high refractive index बताइए कहां से ज्यादा से कम पे जा रही है या कम से ज्यादा पे जा रही है हायर टू लोअर जा रही है हायर टू लोअर नहीं जा रही देखो ये हायर है मैक्सिमम वाली है लोअर वाली तो हायर से लोअर में तो वी कैन से द रे 2 व्हिच इज कॉल्ड अ ऑब्लिक रे व्हिच इज कॉल्ड अ ऑब्लिक रे इट इज बेसिकली ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम हायर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स टू द लोअर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स और वी कैन से देयर इज अ मीडियम टू द lower mid, rare mid. The ray 2 is entering from denser medium to the rare mid. And ray 3 is also entering, traveling from denser to the rare. But ray 1 is traveling in the maximum refractive index region. Okay. So now we can see that the ray 2 is traveling from denser to rare medium. So for denser to rare medium, what will happen? It will bend away from the normal. It will bend away from the normal. That is why its diagram is like this. And similarly for 3. So by in this way we can say that this is a ray 2 or ray 3 will suffer a total internal reflection. Because this is all the energy, all the rays are only traveling within the core part. Only traveling within the core part. So this is the overall picture. This is the overall picture for the gradient index 5. Any doubt from this part? Any doubt? इसके बारे में लिखिए जरा gradient index के फाइबर के बारे में लिखिए अच्छा इसमें देखिए अगर डायमीटर ज्यादा होगा तो ज्यादा फोर्स ट्रेवल कम करेंगे ज्यादा फोर्स ट्रेवल करेंगे या कम मोड ट्रेवल करेंगे अगर बस ज्यादा होगी ज्यादा बंदे बैठेंगे बस कम होगी तो कम बंदे बैठेंगे तो सिमिलर प्रॉब्लम्स If the इसमें नोट लिखिए the diameter of the core is very large. The diameter of the core is large for the stepped index fiber. If the diameter of the core is large, then number of modes can propagate. Then number of modes can propagate through. Then number of modes can propagate simultaneously through the fiber. Simultaneously, number of mode can propagate simultaneously through the fiber. अगर हमारे पास 50 सीटर गाड़ी है तो उसमें 50 बंदे बैठेंगे पर जाएंगे एक साथ 70 वाली है तो 70 की 70 बैठेंगे पर जाएंगे एक साथ ओके देन नंबर ऑफ मोड्स कैन प्रोपेगेट साइमल्टेनियसली थ्रू द ऑप्टिकल फाइबर एंड ईच मोड हैव एंड ईच मोड विल हैव डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ ट्रांजिट टाइम ये समझ आया आपको बात डिफरेंट वैल्यू ऑफ ट्रांजिट टाइम समझ आया देखो जो बस के सबसे पहली सीट पे बैठा है वो क्लास में सबसे पहले पहुंचेगा जो सबसे लास्ट में बैठा है वो सबसे लास्ट तो दिस इज सम टाइम गैप देयर इज सम टाइम गैप सो दिस इज कॉल्ड अ ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन दिस इज कॉल्ड अ ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन जो मोड सबसे पहले जाएगा ठीक है जो मोड मैंने आपको बताया था लास्ट लेक्चर में पहले लेक्चर में इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर में बताया था कि जो उसमें मैंने बताया कि रे नंबर 1 रे नंबर 2 रे नंबर 3 है ना और ए नंबर 1 क्या था कि कम डिस्टेंस ट्रैवल करती है और कम रिफ्लेक्शंस ऑफर करती है फेस करती है और ए नंबर 3 क्या था ज्यादा करती है तो वो ऑब्वियसली इट विल रीच एट द आउटपुट एंड लेटर ऑन रेदर देन एज कंपेयर टू ए नंबर 1 एंड ए नंबर 2 तो So similarly, there is some time gap. This is called a time gap from ray number 1 to the ray number 10 or 12, 12 or ray, on the last ray. So this is called a transit time dispersion. This is called a transit time dispersion. Now let us come to this point. Okay, this diagram. Grid index fiber. Please write light ray 1 travel along the axis of core. Travel along the axis of core. Where the refractive index is maximum. Where the refractive index is maximum. सही कह रहा नहीं कह रहा हूं. रे नंबर 1 इज ट्रैवलिंग अलोंग द एक्सिस ऑफ कोर वेयर द रिफ्रेक्टिव इंडेक्स इज एंड इज मैक्सिमम. अगर रिफ्रेक्टिव इंडेक्स ज्यादा होगा तो इसकी वेलोसिटी क्या हो जाएगी नंबर 1 की? कम हो जाएगी. तो सो दिस रे इज स्लोएस्ट बोल रहा हूं मैं. स्लोली बोल रहा हूं स्लोएस्ट. सो रे नंबर 1 इज स्लोएस्ट. सबसे कम वेलोसिटी किसकी होगी? सो द रे नंबर 1 इज स्लोएस्ट. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट बनाइए. लेट अस कम टू द रे नंबर 2. ओके, फॉर रे नंबर 2 लाइट रे ट्रेवल ब्लीकली का मतलब क्या होता है? जो एक्सिस के साथ कुछ ना कुछ एंगल बना रही हो. ब्लीक मींस इट विल मेक सम एंगल विद द एक्सिस ऑफ कोर. ओके, रे नंबर 2 ट्रेवल ब्लीकली एंड इट इज कंटीन्यूअसली entering in a medium and it is continuously entering in a medium of low refractive index thus it starts bending away from the normal. And simultaneously its velocity increases. ठीक है बिशप? And simultaneously its velocity increases. ठीक है? मतलब ये कैसे हो रहा है? ये ज्यादा ट्रैफिक में से नेशनल हाईवे की तरफ बढ़ रही है. समझाई कि नहीं आई? ज्यादा ट्रैफिक में से नेशनल हाईवे की तरफ बढ़ रही है जहां पे ट्रैफिक कम होता है. ठीक है? Its velocity increases. Next point, third point. Ultimately, ray 2 suffers total internal reflection. Ultimately, ray 2 suffers total internal reflection. Use the red pen. And start approaching the center of the core again. And ultimately, ray 2 suffers total internal reflection and start approaching the center of the core again. Next point. Although ray number 1, see this point is called A, this point is called a B. This point is called A, this point is called a B. Although सबसे कम डिस्टेंस किसने ट्रेवल की है? ray number one travel minimum distance from point A to point B. But its velocity is also minimum. समझ आएगी नहीं आई कि वेलोसिटी क्यों मिनिमम है? व्हाई द वेलोसिटी इज मिनिमम? बिकॉज़ इट इज ट्रैवलिंग इन अ हायर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स रीजन. इट इज ट्रैवलिंग इन अ हायर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स रीजन एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस रिलेशन इफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स इज मोर द वेलोसिटी इज लेस. ओके, नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. कितना पॉइंट? पॉइंट नंबर 5. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, रे नंबर 2 oblique ray travels more distance, but their velocity is also large. क्यों क्यों लार्ज है भाई, वेलोसिटी क्यों लार्ज है? बिकॉज दे नंबर टू ट्रेवल फ्रॉम डेंसर मीडियम टू दी रियर मीडियम, बट देयर वेलोसिटी इज आल्सो लार्ज देन द एक्सियल रे, देन द एक्सियल रे नंबर वन, देन द एक्सियल रे ब्रैकेट में लिखिए रे नंबर वन, एक्सियल रे का मतलब क्या है, रे नंबर वन, देन द एक्सियल रे नंबर वन. लास्ट पॉइंट, हेंस द रे विल रीच फ्रॉम, हेंस द रेज विल रीच फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए टू पॉइंट बी, हेंस द रे रेज, हेंस द रेज विल रीच फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए टू पॉइंट बी इन सेम टाइम इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ पाथ फॉलो, इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ पाथ, मतलब चाहे आप इस रास्ते से आइए चाहे आप उस रास्ते से आइए, चाहे वेदर यू क्वायर पाथ नंबर वन और वेदर यू क्वायर पाथ नंबर टू, द टाइम विल सेम, द टाइम विल सेम, द रे नंबर वन टाइम एंड द रे नंबर टू टाइम विल सेम, दैट इज, इट इज इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द पाथ फॉलोअर, ओके, इंडिपेंडेंट पाथ फॉलोअर. दस प्रैक्टिकली देयर इज नो टाइम, तो इसमें क्या ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन होगा? नो, अगर सेम टाइम पे पहुंच गई तो देयर विल बी नो ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन. दस प्रैक्टिकली नो ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन, दस प्रैक्टिकली देयर इज नो ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन, thus practically there is no transit time dispersion in the gradient index fiber, in the gradient index fiber, thus practically there is no transit. transit tak ka kya kya matlab hota hai, what's the meaning of transit? transit ka matlab hota hai
change,
transit ka matlab kya hota hai, bolte hain transit mein safar, transit ka matlab kya hai, safar, jo hum safar karte hain, theek hai, to light bhi to safar hi tay kar rahi hai na, a se lekar b tak ja rahi hai, to kya hai, मान लीजिए ये है जलंधर जी का जाना, जलंधर से जहां जा रही है वो अलग रास्ते से जा रही है, अलग रास्ते से जा रही है, ओके, दस प्रैक्टिकली देयर इज नो ट्रांजिट टाइम डिस्पर्शन इन ग्रेटर इंडेक्स, नोट लिख लीजिए, नोट लिख लीजिए, रे नंबर टू एंड रे नंबर थ्री ट्रेवलिंग फ्रॉम डेंसर मीडियम टू दी रोअर रेयर मीडियम विद इन द कोर, ठीक है, रे नंबर टू ट्रेवल्स फ्रॉम डेंसर मीडियम टू दी रेयर मीडियम, ray number 2 travel from denser medium to the rare medium, which means that continuously, ray number 2 travel from denser medium to the rare medium continuously, it means that its velocity also increases continuously, it means its velocity, the velocity of ray number 2 also increases continuously. So any doubts on this point? Any doubt from this second index fiber or gradient index fiber? Sometimes this question can also be covered under the capacity of whole marks, especially this part. Okay. तो इसका जो index profile है, तो last एक note लिख दीजिए, The index profile is parabolic in nature. The index profile is a parabolic in nature. तो ये कैसे बन रहा है भाई? Parabola. कैसे बन रहा है? Parabola. This is the shape of parabola. Is parabolic in nature. ये कैसे बन रहा है? Parabolic. Parabolic. ठीक है. The index profile is a parabolic in nature. Okay. Last point. Can you tell me the units of the refractive index?
No.
What are the units of refractive index? What are the units of the numerical aperture? डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट, तीसरा क्या होता है, डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट, क्या है, डायलेक्ट्रिक कांस्टेंट, तीनों के ये तीनों क्वांटिटीज क्या होती हैं, इट हैज नो यूनिट्स. It is a dimensionless quantities. is a dimensionless quantity. So this is a question of Viva. What are the refractive index of numerical aperture? Limitless. NM is numerical aperture, refractive index or dielectric constant. ये तीनों क्वांटिटीज के यूनिट्स नहीं होते. ओके, दीज आर प्योरली डायमेंशनलेस. एनी डाउट ऑन दिस सेक्शन, दिस पार्ट? एनी डाउट? थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.